Hi everybody, Norma here. How are you today? It is Monday, December the 13th, and we are just about to start our final Yoga Nidra of this series. So for those of you who have been following along, welcome back. And if this is your first time, please welcome to the world of Yoga Nidra. I'm excited to be able to share this special practice with you. So nothing for you to do other than to get cozy on your mat in Shavasana. And we're just about at 4:30. I think we are at 4:30. So we'll go ahead and get started. Just making sure that my ringer is off my phone and all those things. So just try to disconnect here and see if you can unplug for the next 45 minutes this time you've carved out for yourself. Taking these first few breaths to arrive here, knowing that there is nothing needed of you for the next 45 minutes other than get started by getting comfy on your mat. Take your time and get extremely comfortable here. So grab anything that you've brought with you for practice. So you'd want to have a yoga mat, and sometimes even if you have extra blankets, you can double up on a blanket underneath you. You're wiggling out any wrinkles that may be in your blankets, grabbing a cozy sweater or socks, because we will be laying down for the next 45 minutes. And as we go through the meditation, we are going through different layers of consciousness, and through that activating our parasympathetic nervous system. And you can get cold as we travel there. So let's take an inhale breath together. Fill up your chest, fill up your belly, open your mouth, sigh, let it all go. Maybe getting out any last wrinkles or fidgets until you find that sweet spot. Begin to arrive. Know that you are completely safe here. Nothing is required of you. This is your time that you've carved out just for you. Trust that you are exactly where you need to be. You are practicing the ancient practice of Yoga Nidra, and you can't do this practice wrong. As we go through the meditation, let my voice be your anchor throughout, and you may drift off, or your mind might begin to wander, and that's okay, these things are expected. Just bring yourself back to my voice, bring yourself back to your breath, and begin again. You may even find that you drift off depending on when you're doing this practice. And if you are laying in your bed doing this practice, that's okay too. Get really, really cozy. And then if you do this later, you might even fall off to sleep. So we'll be focusing on our crown chakra today. If you've been following along, the last chakra of our series, our crown chakra, Sahasrara, is located above the crown of our head, and the color is violet. It is the center of our spirit, enlightenment, vision, and connection to higher guidance, the divine. It helps us with realizing our highest potential, allowing for us to experience unity and connection to the universe, as well as integration of the whole. The mantra for this chakra is, I know. let's take another inhale breath together. Exhale, sighing it out, letting yourself get heavier and heavier here. Starting at the root, imagining this breath starting from your root, Muladhara, up to your sacral chakra, to your solar plexus, to your heart, to your throat, to the third eye, and finally your crown. Maybe even imagining the swirling of bright light just above the crown of your head. Imagine yourself getting heavier and heavier here as your breath becomes effortless. And you feel anchored and safe here by the root, opening up yourself to the experience ahead, knowing that you're completely safe and you can take what you want and leave the rest. Allow yourself to surrender here. Allow yourself to be open and know that the experience that you will have today is the experience that you were meant to have. Imagine yourself now in a place that feels safe. This place can be something that you've created in your imagination. It may be a place that you've visited, or maybe even a place in your home. A place where you feel completely safe. It can be a place in nature, or even in your own bed. Is your place that brings you joy. You feel full of love and peace here, your inner sanctuary. Take the time to allow yourself to feel all of the feels here. Use all your senses to bring this place to life. The sounds, the smell, look around and soak it all in. There might be even somebody there with you. Please feel the energy here in your inner sanctuary. Feel how this energy provides you with peace and love. Comfort and provides nourishment for your whole being, body, heart, and mind. Know that at any time when you want to feel safe, you can come back here. Your inner sanctuary is always with you. Please let yourself go now to your heart space. Feel how your heart is feeling this afternoon, this evening, when you're doing the practice. Truly connect with your heart. Feel how it's feeling today. And once you find that connection, ask yourself this question. What does your heart need to find peace? What does your heart need to find peace? Take the time to hear what your heart has to say. It may come through as images or colors or symbols. Let them come through. From this message that your heart is providing to you, create your intention. Your intention or your sankalpa is your truth vow coming from your heart. Nothing has come to you, that's okay. You can try these. I know deep inner peace. I know deep inner peace. Or, I am love. I am light. Allow your intention to find its way to you, and then repeat it 3 times to yourself as if it's already true in a positive statement. Letting that message coming from your heart fill up your whole body. This is your truth vow. We'll now begin a scan of the body. Allow your awareness to move through each body part as my voice guides you along. Feel each body part as my voice lands there. We feel the body part and connect with it. And then move on to the next as my voice leads the way. Bring your attention, please, to the space above the crown of your head. Location of your crown chakra. Perhaps even imagining a beautiful healing white light here. Your connection to higher guidance. Take the time to feel fully connected here. As we move through the body, imagine this white light weaving through the body parts, connecting your body to your crown as we go along. Feel the top of your head now, the top of your head. Back of your head, and the sides of your head, feel your ears, your right ear, your left ear, insides of your ears, the creases of your ears, the sounds you may be hearing here, feel your eyes. Your right eye. Your right upper eyelid. Right lower eyelid. Your left eye. Left upper lid, left lower lid, allowing your eyes to soften, allow them to soften back in the eye sockets, letting them rest, let them be nourished with the sleep. Notice the space above your lip, your nose, right nostril, left nostril, observing any sensations here, feeling your breath flowing in, flowing out. Feel a space between your lips. Maybe they're parted. Maybe you lick your lips. Feeling your upper lip and your lower lip. Feeling your jaw. Allowing it to soften. Feel your throat. Allow yourself to swallow here. Feeling the sensations. Feel your heart. The space around your heart. Feel your heart. Maybe imagining that white light swirling in your heart. Maybe making it feel a little brighter. Feel the right side of your body now. Right shoulder. Right elbow, right lower arm, right hand, and right fingers. And right hip, and right upper leg. Right lower leg, right ankle, right foot, right toes, traveling up the left side of your body now, feeling your left toe, left foot. Left ankle, left lower leg, left knee, left upper leg, left hip, left finger. Left hand, left lower arm, left elbow, left shoulder. Traveling back up to the top of your head, back to the crown chakra. Now feeling your entire body all together at the same time with this beautiful white light surrounding you from head all the way down to your toes, back up to your head. Feeling your entire body all together, beautifully held here, and imagining this shimmering white light, shimmering throughout your entire body, going from root to crown, crawling through your entire body. Your attention is still on my voice. Bring your awareness to your breath now. Just like when we were doing the body scan, you don't have to do anything. You will notice and observe your breath without needing to change or modify it. Simply observe your natural breath. Feel the inhale and feel the exhale. Feeling the parts of your body where the breath touches it. And if there's an area in your body that might be feeling heavy or stuck, send your breath there. Just breathe. Feel the parts of the body where your breath touches it. Bringing your attention now to the pause between the inhale and the exhale. No need to change anything, just awareness. Maybe you're even noticing that the pause between your breath is becoming less lengthened now and more effortless. Observing where your breath is entering your body now. Maybe noticing the warm sensation in your nostrils, or the warmth in your throat on the exhale, if you're letting a breath pass by your lips. Letting anything go that no longer serves you. Yourself to sink deeper and deeper here. Simply breathe. Send breath now into your heart space. Imagine that flame that you're igniting in your heart. Feeding that flame, letting the glow from your heart fill up your body. And the imagine I am. I am. And with your exhale, at peace. Breathe in light. Breathe in light. Can you imagine a movie screen now in front of your eyes, in your mind's eye? We will now move through feeling different emotions. I will say a word. Imagine the word on the screen in front of you. Please allow yourself to feel the word completely, allowing yourself to be surrounded by the sensations that that word will bring to you. We will then move on to letting the word go completely, letting it dissolve away and move on to the next with my voice, knowing that you're completely safe here. And you can go back to your inner sanctuary at any time. Gratitude. See the word gratitude. Allow yourself to feel gratitude in your body. What does gratitude feel like in your body? Feel gratitude. Let it disappear, let it dissolve away. Thanklessness. Imagine the word thanklessness on the screen in front of you. Allow yourself to feel the emotions the word thankfulness brings to you. Experience how that feels. Emotion of thanklessness. Now feel both gratitude and thanklessness at the same time. Feel the emotions and the differences that these emotions bring to you. Travel back and forth from feeling gratitude and feeling thanklessness. Now let them go, let them dissolve away, let them vanish completely. Blank screen in front of you. Compassion. Allow the word compassion to come alive in the screen in front of you. Feel it in your body. Feel compassion. Now feel indifferent. Allow indifferent to fill your body. See where it lives in your body. Experience those sensations. yourself toggle back and forth from feeling compassion and feeling indifferent at the same time. Feel the differences that these emotions show up in your body. Now let them go, let them fade away. One more time, clear screen in front of you. See the word acceptance. See the word acceptance on that movie screen in front of your eyes. Allow your body to feel acceptance. Where does acceptance show up in your body? Now allow yourself to feel rejection. How does rejection show up in your body? Allow yourself to feel rejection. One more time, feeling acceptance and feeling rejection at the same time, allowing yourself to toggle back and forth through those different emotions, feeling the differences in your body. Acceptance and rejection. Now let that go, let it dissolve away, and let the movie screen vanish as well. Now allow these images to come alive for you as we begin a journey. Use all your senses to bring these images to life. Allowing any smells, symbols, memories to aid in your experience. Taking from the experience what you need and leaving the rest. A new pair of pajamas. A new pair of pajamas. That image come alive, allow any memory to come through. Cozy socks. Cozy socks. Cozy socks. Your favorite blanket. Your favorite blanket. Perhaps you're even practicing with it today. Your favorite blanket. A book. Your favorite book. Maybe a book that you want to read and you've not got there yet. Imagining a book. Your bed. Imagining your bed, your cozy oasis, your favorite animal, maybe your pet, curling up at your feet in your bed. Your favorite animal, curling up the feet of your bed. Drifting off to sleep, beginning to dream. It's a beautiful winter morning. The sun is just beginning to peek out from the clouds, making the clouds appear like big, soft puffs of cotton candy filling the sky. There's pinks and blues and violet surrounding the beautiful puffy white clouds. Cotton candy in the sky. It has just begun to snow. The snowflakes sparkle as the hints of sunlight begin to brighten around the clouds. You wonder to yourself what it would feel like to be lying in the softness of the cloud and to be able to float in that beautiful morning sky amidst the sparkling snowflakes. As though the cloud has read your mind, the biggest, most fluffy, puffy cloud slowly makes its way down to earth. Curious, you reach out and touch the cloud and marvel at the softness, the textures, and the temperature. And you notice steps leading up through the middle of the cloud. You begin to step into the cloud and you see your favorite blanket right there in the middle of the cloud and you decide to lay down. As you lay down, the cloud slowly moves back up into the morning sky. And you marvel at the beauties of the colors in the sky, even more beautiful as you float up, supported by this beautiful cloud. Feeling the safety of the clouds surrounding you, it's caressing you like a beautiful hug from someone you love. You begin to see in your mind's eye part of your life that you've been working on. Something that has been blocking you from reaching your highest potential. Here in the safety of the cloud, floating in the sky, you see yourself releasing it. Letting it go, allowing room for something new. Something that will fill you with gratitude, compassion, and living your truth. Allow yourself to experience all of the sensation this release is bringing to you. Floating amongst the clouds. Feel the peace and the awareness that everything that you need to know is within you. open yourself up to experience all that is available to you. Feel the gentle rocking of the cloud as it slowly, ever so slowly, gently brings you back to earth. You're once again in your bed with your favorite blanket, reminding you of your dream, floating in the cotton candy cloud. Slowly, ever so slowly, bringing your awareness back to my voice. Allow yourself now to revisit your truth vow, your sankalpa, one last time. Repeat it to yourself 3 times as if it's already true. Let your truth fill you up entirely. Let it fill up your heart, providing nourishment and healing to your body, your mind, and your spirit. You know that this truth vow is always part of you, and you can return to it even after our practice is finished. It's always a part of you. Noticing your breath now, bringing your attention back to your breath, maybe even letting a sigh pass by your lips. As you gently bring your awareness back to your body now, maybe observing the sounds in the room that you're practicing in, and then coming back to the sound of my voice, feeling yourself safely supported here by Mama Earth, your mat, this little cocoon that you've made for your practice today. And when you feel ready, no rush in the world, inviting small movements back into your body as you gently wake yourself back up. Maybe even letting the light come back into your eyes. Maybe offering your body one long stretch. Curling up into a ball and turning over to one side or the other, whichever is calling you, and staying in fetal position for a breath or two, using your arm as a pillow, letting your experience soak in. And when you feel ready, bringing yourself up to a seat and bringing hands to heart center, Anjali Mudra, our chin is bowed, gaze is lowered, our eyes are closed. Thanking yourself for being open for your experience today, taking this time to rest and restore your body, your heart, and your mind. Knowing that the experience that you were meant to have is the experience that you had. This is the ancient practice of Yoga Nidra. And this concludes our practice. Namaste. Thank you, everyone. So this concludes our 7-week series. So if you have followed along, please, I hope that you found this practice beneficial. And if you've just started today, welcome. This truly is a really important practice to bring into your overall well-being. It is a practice that becomes easier the longer that you practice it. I've been probably practicing Yoga Nidra for more years than I know, than I can count. I had my 8th year of practicing yoga the other day, and Yoga Nidra was introduced to me very early on, and I feel very blessed to have benefited from the healing properties of Yoga Nidra. So if you have any questions, please reach out to me. If we haven't had an opportunity to meet yet, my name is Norma. I'm part of the wellness team. And we'd like to hear some feedback of this offering and how we might incorporate it into the new year. So please give the feedback. I think Adriana and Ryan are working on getting some feedback. So as far as yourselves for tonight, we have gone on a journey, a little bit higher journey, with ourselves kind of in the clouds, so to speak. So mindful that we need to anchor ourselves as well. So you might find that you want to journal after the session, but I would suggest for everybody to have a quiet evening if you can allow yourself that. Drinking lots of water, trying not to continue on through computers, etc. Sometimes the blue light, because we've delved into these layers of our consciousness, it becomes right there and you will find yourself having trouble to sleep tonight. So we practiced 45 minutes of Yoga Nidra. They say that 30 minutes of Yoga Nidra is like having 4 hours of sleep. That's the benefits of it. Please don't let it replace your sleep, but it's just an example of the healing benefits and this opportunity to get into that rest and digest of our parasympathetic nervous system. We are, you know, in flight response all the time with things coming at us. So the more that you will allow your nervous system to relax and to heal, the better off that you will feel overall, and you'll also be able to handle stressors in your life much more fluidly. So I could go on and on, but please, sorry, I'm right down on the back here because I'm up. So thank you, and I look forward to maybe we will offer this practice not every week as we move forward, but certainly you tell us what you'd like to see, and we look forward to having more and more people come back into the gym as we are offering more programs. And I'll take this opportunity to, I may not see you, to wish you all a very happy holidays, safe holidays with your families, and I look forward to seeing you in 2022. Can you imagine we're saying that? I am teaching a slow flow class, 7:30. There's 6 spots available on Wednesday morning. So if you're on site and you'd like to join, it'd be great to finalize the end of the year. And I'm going to put a shout out to my partner. I am going to revitalize Laurel and my Christmas theme class for those of you that might be interested in that. So namaste, friends, and stay safe, and I will see you again. Thanks for coming out.